So at this point, we have introduced the Metropolis-Hastings algorithm that is designed to draw from complex distributions. And the complex distributions that we have considered are distributions where typically the denominator of the target probability cannot be calculated. We have seen two contexts. One is when you are drawing from a combinatorial set where the number of elements in the set is too big to be enumerated. And the other one is in the context of Bayesian inference where the denominator was a very complex integral of very complex expressions. And we have illustrated this algorithm. Now I would like to apply it to another problem, which is drawing from multivariate probability distribution. And the outcome will be an algorithm called Gibbs sampling. When you want to draw from multivariate distributions, the main difficulty is to deal with the correlations among the different dimensions. So it's easy to draw from independent random variables. It's quite difficult to draw from correlated random variables. So here I denote by capital X a random vector of dimension n, and the PMF, the probability mass function, or the PDF, it does not matter if it is discrete or continuous, is P of X. And the key assumption here is that we assume that we can draw from the marginals. What is a marginal? It means that if among the n dimension you fix n minus 1 of them to a value, so you provide a value for each dimension except 1, and then you consider the unidimensional probability for the remaining variable. And usually it's easy to draw from this because it's unidimensional, and we know how to draw from unidimensional distributions. So that's the assumption. We assume that we are able to do that. Good, we want to apply the Metropolis-Hastings algorithm. Therefore, we have to design a Markov process that will allow us to explore the state space. Assume that our current state is X, an instance of the random vector. We will first select a dimension randomly, okay, a coordinate. So we draw randomly between 1 and n, a value of I. And then what we do is that we use this marginal to draw a new value for coordinate I. So the new state Y is exactly the same state as before, except for coordinate I, where we have replaced xi, the previous value, with the value of r that has just been drawn from the marginal distribution. Again, it's very simple, but we have now to calculate the forward and backward probabilities. So what is the probability that this process moves from state x to state y? Well, first, you need the probability to select the proper coordinate, so it's 1 over n, and the probability to generate the R, given everything else is constant. And this is the marginal distribution. So we have just here translated the process that you have described before in terms of formulation of the transition probability. But now this marginal, we can write it as follows. It can be written as the ratio between the full probability of Y divided by the probability that the x is equal to xj for all coordinates except I. It is interesting to write it like this because if you look carefully, this formulation here does not depend on the current state xi. And actually it makes sense intuitively, right? So what we have done is to identify a coordinate, we have erased the previous value and replaced it with a new one. And this does not depend on the value that x had before. So it makes sense that it does not play a role in the transition probability. It means that qxy is proportional to py. And actually, qyx is proportional to px. When we calculate the accept probability for the Metropolis-Hastings algorithm, the ratio which is here, thanks to the property that we just derived, is equal to this ratio here. And now the nice things happen is that these things cancel out. And the value is 1. So the accept probability is always 1. That's great, because whatever the process is proposing will keep it. It's a very efficient version of the algorithm. Let's take an example. Let's draw from a bivariate normal distribution. Well, of course, this is just for illustration. There are better ways to draw from a normal distribution, but I take this simple example to illustrate the use of Gibbs sampling in this context. I will need to use the marginal distribution. So this is the marginal distribution of the bivariate normal. So if x equals x, the y follows a normal distribution, and the mean is defined by this, and the variance is defined by this. And these are the entries of the variance-covariance matrix that we see here. I took as an example a bivariate normal with mean 0 and a quite high correlation factor, 0.9. So these are the level curves of the true distribution of the PDF of the bivariate normal. And now I have applied the Gibbs sampling algorithm that we just saw. And these are the draws that we have generated. And as you can see, they basically concentrate on the level curves as we saw before. So this works quite well.